Pennsylvania's Laurel Highlands, a haven of sparkling waterways, rolling countryside, natural wonders, and pristine mountains. Pennsylvania's Laurel Highlands, a place of wonder in any season. More information at laurelhighlands.org.
Naturally green. Let's shift gears and take a peaceful walk in the woods. There's over 5,000 acres.
The Bear Run Nature Reserve is 5,500 acres. It's predominantly forested land. There are about 20 miles of trails, and they cover all the different areas of the reserve, from very beautiful stretches that weave along Bear Run up into the ridge, the drier oak forest along the ridge, and all the way down to overlooks on the Youghiogheny River. In 2007, we completed our conservation plan for Bear Run Nature Reserve. And that plan is essentially an inventory, a cataloging of all of the important resources, cultural, watershed resources, forest resources, cataloging all that information and providing a framework for us to make decisions on how we manage the reserve, how we reduce impacts while still balancing a nice experience for folks that want to come and visit.
Our focus here is to manage for nature. Bear Run represents a good example of the eastern deciduous forest, here mixed with the eastern hemlock, which is Pennsylvania's state tree. There's a wide diversity of deciduous trees here. These are the trees that lose their leaves in the winter. It's basically a mixture of a forest type starting higher on the mountain, where it's drier and more acidic, to lower on the mountain where it's still somewhat acidic but higher moisture content and also much cooler. The stream, which starts on the west slope of Laurel Ridge, falls to the Youghiogheny River over the course of a number of miles and dropping over 1,500 feet in that distance. As it does so, it's falling over small cascades and waterfalls. The water quality here is very good. It's listed as an exceptional value stream. It's also listed as a scenic river. So the purity of the water is supporting the very unique types of aquatic life. One of them is the eastern brook trout. It's our only native trout in Pennsylvania. It's also our state fish, a very beautiful fish. But it needs cold water in order to survive, partly because cold water holds more oxygen, and this fish will not do well if the temperature of the stream water becomes very warm. This is why it's important to have forest closure along the stream and large trees and large forest buffer along the stream to maintain that. This fallen tree, which is now a log on the forest floor, represents an important concept in looking at forest habitats and managing them. Here at Bear Run Nature Reserve, we recognize this fallen tree as being an important component of the forest. We don't look at it as a fallen tree as much as we look at it as part of the natural cycles that take place in nature. As it rots away, it maintains moisture. It also provides cover for many different types of wildlife. And there is a whole host of small wildlife, millipedes, centipedes, that will break this log down and have it become part of the soil.
This is a place where we've implemented a management activity as a result of our conservation plan. Part of that conservation plan was to come into these fields that were in active production for hay and restore them to native wildflowers and warm season grasses. We've got probably over 100 trees that were planted right in this specific area. The reason why we wanted to convert these from a hay field is partly to help protect the reserve from the invasion of non-native and sometimes invasive species. It also helps create a healthy native meadow system that's important for native insects and native butterflies and moths. So it really helps increase and sustain our native biodiversity here. Our hope is that Bear Run Nature Reserve will always remain as a healthy, functioning native forest system with lots of wildlife and clean streams.
To learn more about protecting Bear Run, visit our website at greenlifepenn.org.